Kant Cunningham.
I'm Sydney Hilton.
I'm Alicia Burrell.
And I'm Devin Stone, and this is our senior project titled Period Emit. This piece has a lot of use of foul language and drug reference, so if that offends you, please leave. It's okay. Please enjoy the show.
This beauty is the amazing Krablin Theater.
The what?
You know, the Krablin Theater.
I've actually never been in one of these projection rooms before. This is so cool.
Yeah, that's great. Why are we here again?
Because why not? We're having fun. We're being sneaky.
Yeah, besides, it's our last year at the beautiful Lynn English High School. And what's gonna happen when you guys go to college?
I'm gonna be left all alone with no one to get high and commit crimes with. It's tragic.
So let's live in the moment and have fun.
Crimes?
I mean, we are technically breaking in.
Guys, I really don't think coming here is the best idea. I mean, the semester's almost over. I have a lot of homework to do.
I also don't want to get arrested. What were in those gummies?
Don't worry about it. Just go with the phone.
We're not gonna get arrested. I own the place.
Yeah, come on, Josie.
Yeah, shut up, coward.
Hey, Kimmy, what kind of movies did they used to play here?
Yo!
Speaking of movies, what's over here? Oh my gosh, they have Knives Out.
I love murder mysteries.
I thought you hated movies.
I have an exception for crime films. Duh!
We know, you never shut up about it.
I shut up about it.
I can't believe I finally dragged you back here.
Yeah, you know I'm not necessarily fond of the movies.
I thought you'd be over that by now.
So hey, bye. Why do you read movies anyways?
Oh, no, don't get her started.
Well, I'll tell you. I am tired of the movies. Yes, the movies. I mean, look at them. All of these glamorous people get to go on all these amazing adventures. They hog it all. They cobble the whole thing up. And you know what happens? People go to the movies instead of moving. I mean, why is it all of the Hollywood characters are supposed to have all the adventures for everyone in America? Well, everyone in America sits in a dark room and watches them have them. Kind of sad, don't you think? Yes, until something big like a war happens. That is when the adventure finally becomes available to the masses, not just the gables. But I am not patient. I do not want to wait until then, and I will not wait until then. I am tired of the movies, and I want my own adventure.
So why don't you just go out and make your own adventure?
Yeah, like one of those magic treehouse books.
Choose your own lame adventure.
Well, I think this is pretty adventurous.
Maybe for you.
I cannot believe my best friend hates movies.
I can't believe you're my best friend, so.
You know what, Violet? I'm tired of this. You're no longer my best friend. Hazel, so you're my new best friend. Come here, come here. Well, it's just you and me now, companion. From now on, according to rule number 72, we are never allowed to go anywhere without each other, except for the bathroom. It's so awesome because all my friends always end up leaving me. But you can't, okay? Favorite movies. Are you a Star Wars girl or a Star Trek girl? I wanna know everything about you. Personally, I like Star Wars, but I'm willing to like Star Trek more if you think it's better.
Is this the speech you give to all your new friends? Also, yeah. I prefer Star Wars A New Hope specifically.
I've never seen Star Wars.
Good for you.
Also, why is crime film such an exception?
Don't get her started on her true crime bullshit.
I think it's a crime not to like true crime.
Good one.
Okay. I mean, but like, think about it. How can one not be obsessed? Think of how many people go missing and get murdered every single day without a trace as to who did it or what happened. One day, I'm going to be the detective that solves the cases.
Is that your dream, to become a detective?
She wishes.
No. As a matter of fact, I already am. One of you is a murderer. And I am in the position where I've got to place myself in the brain of a crazy, cunning killer. I've got to ask myself what they want us to do and what they themselves are planning to do. I've got to try and keep us one step ahead of them, because if I don't, there's going to be another death. There are four of you here. One of you is a killer. The other of you is the killer's victim. We don't know who it is, but I shall know. But trust me, you are in danger. Whoever you are that's going to get killed. But because nobody who's killed twice is going to hesitate to kill a third time. And let me tell you one more thing. The killer is enjoying this. Yes, they are enjoying themselves a great bit. So, beware!
Are you done LARPing yet?
I am.
Why would you want to put yourself in your murderers?
Desi. Detectives aren't the first ones on the scenes. The murderer will already be gone by the time I would theoretically show up.
Dumbass.
hey, guys. What do you think the store needs? It says 2210.
2210.
Looks like a closet, maybe. I don't know. I've never seen it before.
I say what's supposed to be.
No. Not in room 2210. It's really none of our business. I mean,
what if we find a dead body?
Or Ozzie Mitchell? Or a murderer just waiting there for a three?
Could be such a buzz kill. I say we check it out. It could be something fun.
All right. Let's see what's in here.
Huh. It looks like an awfully big closet. I can't really see anything.
I say we commit and just go straight in.
Yeah. Okay. Uh-huh. Sure. What can go wrong?
I mean, sure. I trust you guys, but this is how you die in movies.
So if this is like the movies, Asher's gonna die first then, huh?
You racist whore!
Sabrina, they're not exactly a witch, because we might be here for a while.
Okay, you guys know how I moved into town, like, about a year ago?
Yeah.
Well, I ran away from home.
Why?
Well, I lived in a small town off of Salem, Massachusetts, and people really didn't think highly of witches there. Let's just say, my family wasn't very well liked.
What the hell did your family do?
We didn't do anything. It's more like we existed.
Okay, that doesn't make any sense.
I know, I'm trying to care. I belong to a long line of practicing witches. And no, not the hocus pocus types of witches.
Dang. a movie,
okay,
though.
Okay, so your family practiced witchcraft. So what?
Well, like I said, the small town that I lived in didn't think highly of witches there. And my family felt ashamed of our family's history and heritage. And they made me feel ashamed for being a part of it.
But what about your family?
They were overbearing. They never wanted us to be seen in public. They were just that ashamed.
Outside in the night, there's a ring around the moon. The wind sings in barbed wire. I've listened to the tune. What seems like 50 years, or maybe hard to count the days when you're buried alive. Outside of these walls is a bigger world than me. I had nowhere to hide the last time I was free.
Leave behind
a window without bars.
anywhere to go see friends, that is, if I had any friends. And my grandmother was the only good thing left, and after she passed, I had nothing. So I left. I left that damn town and everyone who hated me. My parents were so overprotective and worried that I would be hated just like they were, and why they never left, I could never understand.
Damn. That sucks. I'm sorry.
I don't know what to say.
I'm so sorry.
It's all right. I got away from there, and that's the only thing that matters to me.
Yeah, you have us now.
And we're never gonna let you go!
Violet?
Oh, no! We're having a cute friendship moment. Do you want to join, maybe?
Seriously? Look, I'm sorry you felt trapped or whatever, but you still had a living family. How could you just get up and leave?
Did you seriously not listen to any of that?
I listened, and I still don't understand. I mean, how could you leave your family like that? Why not try to convince them to go with you?
I tried, but they would never listen. I could never understand their reasoning for staying in that god-awful town.
You know, you should have tried harder. You don't just give up on family. You're a heathen. If you want to be treated like your heritage, I'll treat you like a witch.
Violet, can't you just try to be nice?
You bid me treat a witch with kindness, Josie. It is God's will that we must burn the witch. Do you think we lie when we say we wait to light the fires?
I know you do not, Violet. They wait for us even now.
Tell me, Hazel, will you be so brave when you feel the fire wrap around your skin and smell the smell of your own flesh cooking? Will you?
I don't know, Violet. If you ask him I'm afraid to die, then yes, I shall answer, I'm afraid. And if you wish I ask to live, I will again say yes, I wish to live. But I will not condemn God to lie.
You heard the others make their confessions. Do you call them liars?
I never called them anything but friends.
Do you hear that? The witch claims you are her friends. But how can we be certain? How can we be true? If you are telling the truth, then repent yourself. God will give you the power to see how evil it is to choose the heart of Satan like you have. Tell me, Hazel, are you prepared to meet the flames?
I can make no confession. Why are you, my friend, treating me like this? What did I do to deserve to get burnt? It's not my fault we both didn't have picture-perfect lives. This is uncalled for.
Well, anyway, we're still stuck here, so what do you need to do?
Well, maybe it could be the reason, because I'm here because I shouldn't be ashamed of my family's history, maybe even try to embrace it. I've always been attracted to witchy stuff in that kind of area, but I always put those feelings aside because of my family.
Well, where are your family now?
Oh, I just noticed it was lighting up.
Well, doors aren't supposed to take you to the 1600s either, but
whoa, the door glows, that's a surprise.
Damn, I guess that was why I was sat here. That got really sad.
Yeah.
I did not expect to pour out my life story today.
Yikes.
Well, it happens to the best of us. But now that that's out of the way, let's head through the door and get out of here.
Thank you.
Ah.
Yeah, let's get going, I guess.
Whee!
Hey, Hazel, shit. I'm so sorry. I didn't mean any of that. I really didn't. But we have our moments.
Thank you.
door take us to London for that?
I mean, guys, look at the atmosphere. Look at the buildings. This has to be the 1800s at least.
Okay, and that means what exactly?
That means Jack the Ripper era.
Woo!
This is terrifying.
No, this is awesome. Oh, whoa. Do you guys think I had to go find the case files and, like, actually hold them?
Well, they'd be a little hard to find.
And don't you already know everything about that case?
Okay, but it's different than seeing them in the time that they were made and in person.
Isn't that also illegal?
Wow, these are some really great points, guys. Maybe we should just walk around and be his next victim.
No,
yes!
No, let's go find them.
Okay, you guys help me look through these, and maybe we can find something.
Ew, this one's all bloody and gross.
Yeah, that is gross. How do they even investigate blood during this?
Well, that's kind of the reason why they never really got far in old cases like these. They didn't have anything.
Ooh. Well, you know, I watched a show called Cold Case Files, and on Cold Case Files, they solve old murders. And what I've learned is that it's really easy to get away with murder back before they knew about blood and DNA. Like, ridiculously easy. One guy would walk up and be like, "Detective, there's a pool of the killer's blood in this hallway." And then the guy would just be like, gross, mop it up. Now then, back to my hunch. I got it. We will draw chalk around where the body is. That way we know where it was. And see.
Guys, this is so freaking cool.
This one has so much blood and gore. Wow, you gotta check this out.
Oh, wow, lots of dismembering.
You guys truly find the strangest things.
Oh my goodness, guys, I think this was someone's murder plan. Guys, I'm gonna read it to y'all. This is cool, okay. Our course will seem too bloody as we cut off the head and hack off the limbs, like envy and wrath and death afterwards. Let us be sacrificers, but not butchers. And in the spirit of men, there is no blood. Oh, to think we could come across him and not kill him. He must bleed. Let's carve him as a dish fit for the gods, not as a dish fit for the carcasses. This shall make our purpose necessary and not envious, for he can do no more. Then Caesar's had when Caesar's arm is cut off. I said that the wrong way. It's okay.
Well, you were rude. Anyways, are you done geeking over loss of limbs?
You know, as much fun as this is, we aren't really getting anywhere, and we need to figure out what you're doing here so you know we can go.
If it's anything that would happen to me, then we just need to figure out why you're here.
Oh, no, I know why I'm here. I'm here to solve the case.
But you've known this case ever since you were little. There could be another reason.
No, I don't think so. I know I was sent here to solve the case.
But, Carly, we can't just stay here forever waiting for you to solve the case.
I have to solve the case. This is my chance, and I'm going to do it.
Okay, why do you need to solve this case so badly?
Why are you being nice to me after I was such a bitch to you like 5 minutes ago?
I'm not gonna save the past over some petty argument. Hi, I forgive you.
Okay, I've never really talked about this, so excuse me, but when my dad was murdered, I was told that no one would be able to solve it. I was told that it was impossible, and nothing was harder than not knowing. I one day came across the Ripper case, and it led me down a rabbit hole into getting into true crime and unsolved documentaries. I used it as a way to cope. I thought there were just so many cases out there that needed to be solved a step further. And I thought maybe I could become the detective that solves them. And being sent here, I thought maybe if I solved such a big, huge, famous case, I could solve my dad's. And that's why I reacted so harshly when we talked about family.
I never knew that about you. I want you to know I'm here for you. I understand.
I appreciate it, I do, but I don't think you do understand because I can't just run away.
I'm just trying to help.
Something's fallen away.
Reminds me of this case file I once read. It was about a detective who basically said he was giving up on the case. At the time, it got me so angry. I was so mad at a detective being so hopeless about his own job. But I think I understand it now, because what he was saying was about crime statistics. The average person in America gets married twice, and the average children of those marriages spend an average of 2 to 4 hours watching
around 5 hours of television 5 nights out of a week. More than half of that is spent watching violent crime. Over 276 variations of criminal actions based on a 23-episode season. When you expose one half of all Americans to around 300 cases of murders, rapes, kidnappings, and assaults over the course of a season of television, you are creating precisely 500,000 potential major felons a night. Within the next 10 years, there is a precise number of 48,678 of those who will actually commit violent crimes. Actual numbers. Okay, let's talk about those. Every single second, 200 babies die in this country alone. 200 babies. Within the last 10 minutes, 300 people just lost their watches across 38 different states. How are we supposed to do it all? There are so many people that will never be found. So, so many. Now that I've put myself in your shoes and think about it, I mean, it's okay, right? I mean, it's impossible to solve everything in life, and that's okay.
Not every case gets solved, and it sucks, but how things are.
Yeah, I mean, my dad wouldn't want me to go into my 20s stuck on something uncontrollable. I guess I could just use my love for him to solve as many cases as I can when I get older.
Oh. Jeez, Vi, that was so awesome, it didn't even sound like you.
Yeah, how long has it been since you talked about guts and gore again?
All right, guys, I think we can go. I know why I'm here. I just need to understand that it's okay. Everything's okay.
Yeah!
Okay.
All right.
Come on, Kimmy.
I come up here every night. This is what I do for a living. I come up here and give you the best I can. I'm only a human being. I'm not God, you know. I may not be the most popular girl in the world. That's besides the point. I really don't care what you think about me. I mean, who the hell are you anyways? You call me up and you tell me things about myself? You don't know me. You don't know anything about me. You've never seen me. You don't know what I look like. You don't know who I am, what I like, what I don't like in this world. I'm just a voice. A voice in the wilderness. The world is a terrible place. Cancer and garbage disposals will get you. A war is coming, and the world is shot to hell, and you're all goners. Maria! Hey, I'm not done here. People are happiest when others are in pain. That's where I come in. I'm here to lead you by the hand and take you through the dark forest of your own hatred and anger and humiliation. I'm providing you a public service.
Kimmy!
Fine.
Thank you.
plain old me, and plain old me wants to be at home. I can't believe it's come to this. All right, here I go. I do want to be the life of the party, Mr. Door, but I'm scared.
Mr. Door, please understand and just let me go home. Please.
Patterns in my life that I face every day. Patterns as I say the things I always say. Patterns in the ceiling as I lie awake. Patterns in the ways I try but never change. Just look as I'm thrown a curve again. I leap. Then
Can be
be seen and be heard. I want to sing when my heart is full. I want to sing and I want to fly. I'm going to soar with a sigh without a cry.
To be here, frankly, I feel right at home.
Placed
that supposed to mean? Oh, I mean, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to, you know, get all of...
Don't apologize, or some people might think you're capable of sympathy.
As long as it's not empathy.
Anything but that.
Are you guys done yet?
Oh, shit. Okay.
Oh,
yeah.
I've been wondering what you've been writing this week.
Fire!
Nothing. Nothing important at all.
Well, I guess we'll find out.
Oh, boy.
Hazel Bishop is truly the most complex and fascinating person I've ever met. And her constant and relentless pursuit of truth, logic, and reason fascinates me in the same proportion as her obstinacy and unnecessary heroics drive me to distraction. But I love her for it in the same manner that I love Asher for making the gesture of catching a long Bible center seem like God in my eyes. But often I hold back showing my love and affection for Hazel because I think she might misinterpret it. It just happens to be my instinctive feeling that Hazel is a gayfer. And it bothers me. Do you see why I find myself interesting? Here's a girl of my own faith and background, potentially intelligent and talented, who within 6 weeks has come to the brilliant conclusion that a cretin like Kimmy is gonna win the Golden Globe Award. And I, her most esteemed and dearest friend, is a cottagecore lesbian. And it just seems...
Okay, Hazel, if anything, it was a compliment.
Put aside my face.
All right, well, everything's good now. You can go home.
Yeah, but I kind of miss it.
Yeah, I feel like a new person.
That's great for you guys.
Yeah, I mean, you guys got your moments and everything, but...
Yeah, I just feel like something's missing.
You know what? Fuck you guys, I'm going back in.
Oh, wait, not Asher.
Asher, it could be dangerous. We don't
know what happened.
Wait, it's time to run in heels. Guys, wait.
Something bad could happen. Something very bad.
Fuck you.
can leave.
You guys can't just look like that, though.
We look very good.
Okay, yeah, the pants are cool and whatever, but
he's a little possessed.
All right,
come on, let's get all dolled up. Come on.
Okay, this is supposed to be special for you, so for 1 hour and 1 hour only, I shall be your loyal servant.
Thank you.
I'd like my hair and my nails done.
As you wish, Countess.
Oh, that stuff is burning my scalp. What do you do?
Be brave. 1 minute more.
Oh.
Come on, Countess. It's going to be so worth it.
This stuff is dribbling down my neck.
Be brave.
Oh, my nerves. Oh, my goodness.
10 seconds. We must only suffer 10 seconds to be beautiful.
Tre gayness de pack.
Oh, no. This is jungle red. We don't have tre gay. Everyone is wild about it, though. You know Miss Josie, the best dressed woman in New York? Yeah, she wears it. Haha. There, Countess, at last, the agony is over. Whew. Now, we don't want to do your stockings yet because we'll smear your beautiful big toes nail polish.
Elons infantras de la patrie! On to the mud mask!
As you wish!
Thank you. So, as I was saying, I woke up this morning, and for no good reason, I felt the time has come to change up my hairdo.
Is that so? All right, well, it looks like Asher's gonna be about 5 more minutes, so.
Who would you like to do your nails?
I'd like the girl that does Asher's nails.
Oh, I'll see what I can do. God, I'd love to do Asher's nails right down to the wrist with a nice big buzzsaw with the way they've been acting as of recent.
They're a good friend underneath.
Underneath what?
You don't humor your friends enough.
So that's what you're doing here. You're humoring me.
Will y'all stop messing around?
Asher, don't be a buzzkill. Kimmy, I know how much you love Marilyn Monroe, and Josie, I know how much you love a good little dance number, so why don't we have ourselves a little fun?
No.
Yes!
Hit it!
A girl's best friend. A kiss may be grand, but it won't pay the rental on your humble flat. Men grow cold as girls grow old, then we all lose our charms in the end. But square cut or pear shape, these rocks won't lose their shape.
Last
we're in a movie right now.
I mean, you can't deny it. Today
literally feels like a movie.
Strange as it may sound, movie stars are human, relatively human, after all. And it's hard living up to an image on a screen that is 40 or 50 feet tall. If the world were like the movies, we would never make mistakes. We'd correct our better takes, and the person that we should be would be all the public sees. For if life should go off track, we could simply fade to black if the world were like the movies. Think if marriages were movies, how our lives would be improved. Love preserved on film forever. The battle scenes removed. We'd have only happy endings. We could edit as we please. Cut to smiling man and wife with a baby and a life. If the world were like the movies, and the child would have a father who was always there, playing games and flying homemade kites, cheering at their high school plays, tucking them in bed on stormy nights. Never absent, never cruel, not a drunk, not a fool, a father who could give his daughter blue lights and pink lights. Never break her heart. She would never see me stumble, and I'd never let her down. I'll be sober, wise, and humble, the defender of the crown. Well, thank God she has my movies to see.
Always been.
just broke out.
I'm sorry. I know how much you love it here.
I just can't leave yet. Like, it just all happened so quick.
Well, it's not like you'll forget it, because you'll be seeing the 80s from your retirement home. Or you'll be my servant. I haven't decided yet.
A servant's life is not an easy one. But then again, whose life is not but fun? Who does not sometime, somewhere in one's life experience a small degree of strife? And though I may have more than others felt the gnaw of hunger tightening at my belt, or once infrequently been forced to greet the frosty nip of winter at my feet, a servant's life may have its ups and downs, but truly, do the heads that wear the crowns lie easier than ours? I say nay. Nay.
Why do you keep doing this? We done?
Fine. Sometimes she'd even try to sneak into the projector rooms to smoke and listen to her new CDs. I guess this was the theater she'd talk about.
Okay, cool. But can you hurry up and figure out what we're doing here so that we can go?
Well, I was trying to just go sit over there and think for a minute.
Why do you keep doing this? Do you not trust us? We're here to help.
We accepted help from each other because of all of our issues and come to terms with them. Everything we've done so far, we've done as a group.
Yeah, we just want to help you solve whatever problem it is so we can all leave.
So please, Asher, just stop being a little bitch, stop running away from us, and let us help you.
Why do you have such a stick up your ass? Why can't you just leave me alone and let me do what I need to do? Maybe I don't want to leave.
What do you mean you don't want to leave?
We have to, or else we don't know what's going to happen to us.
Dude, this is at least the 90s. We aren't even born yet.
I guess we could run the risk of altering time. And never being born. Just like Back to the Future! Sorry.
You know what? I've had enough of this.
Jump the fence to the other side. Is it good? Is it good?
You boldly settle all important questions, but tell me, dear, isn't it because you're young? Because you haven't had time to suffer till you've settled a single one of your questions? You boldly look forward. Isn't it because you cannot foresee or expect anything terrible? Because so far life has been hidden from your young eyes. You are bolder, more honest, deeper than we are. But think only, be just a little magnanimous and have mercy on me. I was born here. My father and mother lived here. My grandfather too. I love this movie theater. I couldn't understand my life without this movie theater.
I'm sorry, guys. I didn't mean to cause a whole fight. I just feel like if I'm leaving my mom behind, you know, because I have no family left. My mom was an amazing person. She was a great baker, but none of us deserve it, having shit with our parents, not having the childhood of dreams. Not saying mine was Brady Bunch or the Full House, but I didn't have it as bad as you guys. My mom told me she wanted to be an artist, but one day I just saw her get trapped under this thing that happened to her in her not so perfect childhood, and I watched it change her. By the time I was in middle school, she liked to keep the windows drawn and not leave the house, and I just watched her change. When she died, she left the world like a whimper, and I wanted to just reach in there and bring her out of it, and I thought I could.
Asher, you taught us that family isn't just by blood, and that found family is just as important as blood family.
Yeah, we might butt heads, like, a lot, but we're your family, we do care for you.
One effed up family, huh?
Asher, you are my best friend, and I didn't mean for all this to gang up on you like that. I just wanted you to know that you can trust us and that we're here for you.
Thank you.
show. You never know until you go. That rhymed!
Yes, it did, but if you guys remember, the door did give us a chance to stop halfway through, but we didn't.
Yeah, you're right.
Stubborn.
And we'll have no idea what happens to us in the future. So,
what if we went through it again?
Dude, for what?